Hey everyone, welcome to Coding Simplified, and today we'll see the second video on heap. So basically in our first video we explained all about heap, like what is heap, then when we should use heap. So in our first video we basically explained thoroughly that how internally heap works. Now the point is, in Java we have a library function which basically implements the heap, right? So this is the priority queue. So using priority queue we can implement the heap. Because the point is that now we'll see the applications, that the application where we can implement the heap. So if we are seeing the application, then we'll not write the whole internal implementation, like how it insert the value or how it removes the value, because that we have already seen. So now we'll see that how you can implement the heap using priority queue. So here I have some of the values where I have put all the values in array. And this is how I have implemented the minimum heap, and then I'm calling the maximum heap. So basically I'll show you that how we can implement the min heap or how we can implement the maximum heap using priority queue. So now what happens, that first of all let's check the minimum heap. Now this is the minimum heap. So in minimum heap what happens, this is how you basically initialize the priority queue. So when you initialize the priority queue, then by default it basically initialize the minimum heap. Right? So if you are not giving any value here, then it means you are basically implementing the minimum heap. So here you give that all the values whichever I am passing, that will store the integer. Right? So this was about the minimum heap. Now in the maximum heap, whenever you will initialize for the maximum heap, let's say if you want to implement the maximum heap. In this case, you basically give a one more value in the constructor. This is collections.reverse order. So what it does, it basically implement the maximum heap. So it says that normal order is the incremental order, that I start from the lower value and then go till the top value. But if you give this collections.reverse order, then it basically do in the reverse manner. So basically it's kind of a comparator. So it says that comparator. So basically comparator means that when you are giving the reverse order, then it will compare the value in the reverse manner. It means first of all it will set the highest value, then till the lower value, right? So this is the difference. Whenever if you want to initialize the minimum heap, then you initialize just like this. And if you want to initialize for the maximum heap, then you initialize the priority queues like this, right? Now we have another way also, like we can use a different way of comparator. So when you will see in this series the new problems later, so then you will see the different variations of the priority queue that we can use that. Now first of all, this is how, first of all, I am implementing the minimum heap. So I have initialized the priority queue, right? Now what I do, now I am basically filling all the values. So let me write all the values so that I will also show you that how it is, whether it is working fine or not. So here I have 10, 7, 11, 5, 2, 13, 1 and 45. So now what I am doing, that first of all, for each value I am putting the value in the heap, and then I am also printing the heap.peak so that you get to know that whether it is working fine or not, right? So first of all what will happen, let me put a debug point here so that I will keep on doing that, and you will also get to know that whether it is working fine or not. Now first of all it is initializing the priority queue, and then we are adding the value in the heap. So it means this is the first value, so we are adding here. Now If we basically calculate the peak value, in this case my peak value is 10. So you can see here it is printing 10. Now again we are adding the new value. So now we are adding 7. So this is how it adds the value here. Because now 10 is obviously greater than 7. So now because we are implementing the minimum heap, it means it will basically swap the values. So it means 7 will appear here and 10 will appear here. So now my structure will be something like this. Right. So now if you print the peak value here, so now you can see that it is printing 7, right? Because peak will always give you the array of 0. It means peak will give you this one. So internally it is implementing, it will give you the peak value. So now it is giving you 7. Now you are adding 11. So when you add 11, it means this 7 is less than 11. So now it won't do anything. So like here we add the value, and then if you calculate the peak value, again it will give you 7, because 7 is still on the top. Now you are adding 5, right? So when you add 5 here, it means you are adding value here. Now 5 is less than 10, it means it will swap the value. So 5 will be appearing here and 10 will appear here. Now again, because 5 is less than 7 also, so again it will swap the values and 5 will here and 7 will be here. So now I have values like this. Here I have 5, 7 and then 10 and 11. So now now if you see here, you have added the value. Now if you print the peak, so you can see that it is giving you 5 because it has printed this 5 in the top value. Now you are adding 2. So now when you add the 2 value, you will add here, you are adding this 2. So now what will happen? This 2 is less than 7, it means it will swap the value. So 7 will appear here and 2 will appear here. Now again, this 5 is greater than 2. So again, this will swap the values. Now 2 will be here and 5 will be here. So if I print something like this, now my tree is something like this. Here I have 5, here I have 10, here I have 7 and here I have 11. Right? Now if you print the values here, so now let's print the value. Now you will see that it has printed 2 because now your minimum value is 2, right? Now your next value is 13. So if your next value is 13, so 13 will be inserted here, and because 11 is less than 13, so now it will not suffer. Now our next value is 1. So when you add 1 here, then 1 is less than 11, it means it will swap the value. So now 1 will be here and 11 will be here. Now here again, because 2 is greater than 1, so again it will swap the values, and 1 will be here and 2 will be here. So now if you add the value and print the value, right? So this was the case when we added 13. Now here we have added 1. So now if you see, so now it will give you the peak value as 1, right? And now you are adding 45. So 45 will be added like this. So because 45 is the greatest value, so it means we won't do anything here. So let me run here as well. So it means again my top value is 1, right? So now it means we have seen that how we are inserting the values in this. So this is how we can add the value in the heap, and you have seen that it is maintaining the property, minimum heap property. Now we are also calculating that, let's say, how it is maintaining the property when we are removing the values. So now if you see, poll means we are removing the value, right? So peak basically just give you the top value. Top value means the first array of 0. So whether if it is a minimum heap, then it will give you the smallest value, and if it is a maximum heap, then it will give you the largest value. So peak will give you the maximum heap, maximum value, and poll will basically also give the value, but the point is it removes the value. Peak doesn't remove the value and poll removes the value, right? So now what happens that when we do poll, it means now we are removing the value. So it means now I am removing this 1, right? So when you're removing this 1, it means you remove this 1 and then you copy the last value. So now from this 45 will be here. So now 45 will reach here, right? And then we shuffle the value. So how we shuffle the value? We check that whichever the less value is, that will replace with this one. So now out of 2 and 5, 2 is less value. So it means 45 will be appearing here and 2 will appear here, right? Now because 45 is again greater than this 13 and 11, so again it will check which child is lesser. So 11 is lesser. It means 11 will appear here and 45 will be appearing here, right? So after removing the value, if you talk about the peak value, so you will get the peak value as 2. So run the program here and you will see that it is printing 2. Right? Now again we are removing the value. So again you are removing value means you are removing this 2. So it will basically copy this 45, right? And then it will place here because this is the last value. So now 45 will be here and now we have removed the 2. So now because it will swap the value, so now it will check that which value is lesser, 5 or 11, 5. So it means 5 will be appearing here and 45 will appear here. Now again it will check because 45 is greater than this 10 and 7. So now it will swap with this 7 because 7 is lesser. So now 7 will appear here and 45 will be appear here. So after this code, after this one, now my code is something like this, that here I have 5, then here I have 7, here I have 10, here I have 45, here I have 11, and then here I have 13. Right? So again, what is the peak value? Peak value is 5. It means it will print 5 here. So now you can see it is printing 5. Right? Now again, if you remove the value, so what will happen? It will remove the value. Now it will basically replace the value here, because this is how it happens, right? So if you have any confusion like how it is happening, you can see the first heap video, right, where we have explained each and everything. So now once we copy it here to here, it will basically remove this node. Now 13 will check that which value is lesser, 7 and 11. So 7 is lesser, it means 13 will appear here and 7 will appear here. Now because 13 is greater than 10 also, so now again it will swap the values and 10 will be here and 13 will be here. So now what is peak value? Peak value is 7, right? So now if you print the values here, then it will print 7, right? So again, if you poll the values, then again it will give you the minimum value out of the array. Again, if you poll the value, then it will give you the minimum out of frame, right? So this is how basically, and at the last, when you have the single element remaining, so you can see that at the last, when you have only 45, then it removes the value, and after that, it is giving you null because there is no such element, right? So this is how basically the minimum heap is happening, right? And now let me show you the maximum heap as well. So for maximum heap, that is important point. How you initialize the priority queue? You need to initialize with this collection.reverse order, right? And then you are adding the value. So just like we added the value in the minimum heap, here also it will basically add the value in the form of the maximum heap. So whenever you add any value, it basically maintain internally as per the maximum heap property. So what will happen? Because this is the first value, so now first value will be 10. So this is why it is giving you the peak value is 10. Now your next value is 7. So because 7 is lesser, so it won't do anything, right? So if you add here, you can see that again my top value is 10. Now your next value is 11. So when your next value is 11, it means it will swap the values because it is maintaining the maximum heap. So 11 will be here and 10 will be here. So now if you run the program, you can see the 11 is the top value. Now your next value is 5. So if your next value is 5, it means because this is lesser, so it won't do anything. So if you again run the program, it will give you 11 as a top value. Now your next value is 2. So your next value is here. It means again this is lesser value, so it won't do anything, right? Now your next values is 13. So 13 will be adding here. Now because 13 is greater than 10, it means it will swap the values. So 13 will be here and 10 will be here. Again 13 is greater than 11, so again it will swap the values. 13 will be here and 11 will be here. So what is peak value now? 13. So if you run the program, you can see, because so this was the thing when we added 2, now we have added 13. So if you see the peak value, you can see this is the peak value 13. Now if you add 1, so 1 will be adding here, so because 1 is lesser, so it won't do anything. Now we are adding 45. So because 45 is greater than here, so it means swap the values. So now it will be 45, it will be 5. Again 45 is greater than 7, again it will swap the value, so 7 will be here and it will have the 45. Again 45 is greater than this one, so it will swap the values. 13 will be here and 45 will be here. So if you run the program, you can see now we have added 45, right? So this is how it has added the value, and this is how it is maintaining the maximum heap property whenever you are adding any value. On the same note, whenever you are removing any value, there as well it will maintain the property. So now once you remove the value 45, so let me write the value here again. So now I am removing the top value. So when you remove the top value, then you copy the last value here, 5, right? It means this is done. Now it will check that which is a greater value. So now here 13 is greater value, so it will swap the values, and now it will place 5 here. Again, because this 5 is lesser than this one, so again it will swap the value. 7 will be here and 5 will be here. So if it is the top value is 13. So if you run the program here, then it will print 13, right? Now if you again remove this, now you have removed this, it means it will copy this one here. Now it will check which value is greater. Now 11 is greater, so it means 11 will appear here and 1 will appear here. Now because 1 is less than this one, so it means it will swap the values. 1 will be here and 10 will be here. So now if you run the program, then it will give me 11 as a peak value, right? Now let's say if you again remove this, so if you again remove this, it should give me 10, right? So this is how it is happening, that whenever it is removing the value, it is maintaining the top property, right? So now it is giving me 10. After removing the 10, then it would give me 7 is the maximum, then it would give me 5, then it would give me 2, then it would give me 1, and then at the last it will give me null, because all the values are blank from the heap, right? So this is the way so that we can implement the minimum heap and maximum heap using priority queue, right? Because the point is that whenever you are solving any problem, now your aim is not to do internal implementation of heap. Your aim is to basically execute that. And in Java, we have this very good function, library function, which is inbuilt priority queue. So using this one will basically solve our question, right? So that's it for this video, and now our setup is ready, that we have understood that how we can use the heap using priority queue in Java. And now we will solve the actual problems. We'll see the actual implementation, that where we can use the heap, right? So in our next heap series problems, we'll be solving the multiple problems which we can implement using heap, right? So that's it about this video. And if you have any doubts, then please write in the comment section and I will try to explain that. And I will also put the source code into description section. So if you want, then you can also get it from there. So that's it. And if you have liked the video, then please like it and subscribe the channel for more such video. Thank you.